We interrupt your regularly scheduled programming to bring you the most important breaking news in the field of nutrition.
Hey.
Joe Rogan has invited Gary Taubes to a live debate with a PhD neuroscientist and expert on obesity.
What the?
You can't make this up. You can't ignore this one, so don't look away. Boom, hit that subscribe button. Y'all know what time it is. Most of you should already be familiar with Gary Taubes, the science journalist and low-carb promoter. So, who's he going to debate? That's where this gets interesting. Stephan Guyenet is one of the PhD nutrition experts who has an active social media presence on Twitter. His academic background is in the neuroscience of obesity and eating behavior, being widely published and cited in the scientific journals. I think it's safe to say, this guy is one of the leading contemporary critics of the carbohydrate insulin model of obesity, which is essentially Gary Taubes' golden calf. Stephan Guyenet and Kevin Hall stirred the pot last year in 2018 when they publicly took issue with a paper from Dr. David Ludwig that was all over the headlines back then. So this guy is no stranger to the work of Gary Taubes, nor the carbohydrate insulin model of obesity. In fact, Guyenet has even authored some critiques of how the $40 million Nutrition Science Initiative, or NUSI, joint venture between Gary Taubes and Peter Attia collapsed in infamy. One of the main purposes of NUSI was to investigate and validate the carbohydrate insulin hypothesis of obesity. And $40 million later, that didn't work out so good. Aside from a few mainstream media appearances with mild-mannered detractors like Dean Ornish, it's a very rare occasion that Gary Taubes engages in public discourse with serious researchers in the field of nutrition. Many people in the discussion on Twitter have already asserted there's no way Gary Taubes will even show up for this debate. One person even said it's a little ridiculous to have a journalist debate a scientist about nutrition. Some of the memes being posted on Twitter are pretty funny. But hopefully, even if Gary chickens out like everybody is predicting, Joe Rogan will continue to use his platform for discussions like this.
Hey! Okay. Shit, stop!
We're gonna start without Beef Supreme!
Look, y'all, whether or not Beef Supreme wants to show up and defend his life's work, or tuck his scrambled eggs between his legs, it's important to realize this is not about vegans versus meat eaters. Joe Rogan's platform has become one of the most important resources where nutrition is being discussed, and I don't even think Stephan Guyenet is a vegan, and you guys can figure that out on your own. I don't think he is. But the very idea of having a debate like this wasn't even on the table until a few months ago. Well, what changed, guys? I think this opportunity for discussion is a direct result of the Twitter confrontation between Kevin Bass and Joe Rogan, which I outlined in the video I'll link above in the card. This is also what led to the discussion between Bio Lane and Dom D'Agostino on the Joe Rogan podcast, and that Chris Kresser, Dr. Joel Kahn debate. It all goes back to that confrontation between Kevin Bass and Joe Rogan. I'm telling you guys, you gotta see that video if you wanna understand the summary of what happened in the first 1150 episodes of the Joe Rogan podcast related to nutrition and why he got confronted in the first place. This is when the change started. And this has elevated the discussion since then in so many ways. But it all goes back to accountability and Joe Rogan having an open mind. Joe, if you're watching this, thanks for doing the podcast. And all of you watching out there, let me know what you think in the comments down below. Do you think the discredited journalist Gary Taubes will show up for a live debate with a PhD expert on obesity? We'll see. Make sure to hit subscribe for more exclusive insights and analysis. Y'all know what time it is. red pill vegan. Next. Thank you.